Police have shot a man in Melbourne after coming under attack in the city's north. Sam Cucciara is at Greenvale. Sam, what happened?
Well, Mark, it was certainly a terrifying ordeal for these police officers this morning. I just want to show you where we are at the moment. This is actually the car we understand was involved in this ramming. You can see there it's burnt out, parked on the side of the road, a few minutes drive away from where this incident all unfolded. It was just before 5 o'clock this morning when the front of a divvy van was rammed. Two cars carrying two men have then fled the scene, and around the corner they've gotten into some sort of shootout with police. These men have opened fire at officers, and that's when terrified police, fearing for their lives, have been forced to fire back. They struck one of those men, a man in his 20s, in his upper body, and he was taken to hospital in a serious but non-life-threatening condition, and that's where he remains this morning under police guard. Meanwhile, the other man arrested at the scene has also been taken back for police questioning. I've spoken to some locals here at the scene this morning.
Very quiet, very nice, quiet little spot. Didn't expect this to happen 5 metres from the front door.
To think something like this happened so close, it's pretty scary.
As we go to air this morning, there are a number of crime scenes just like this one in place across Melbourne's northern suburbs. Police suspect these two men may have been involved in a string of other early morning crimes, including potentially two attempted ram raids where they tried to steal ATMs. Mark, I'll have the very latest for you throughout the day as I get it.
OK, Sam, thank you. More than a dozen mothers have been arrested in raids across Sydney's west, accused of selling their children's identities to a family daycare scam. This report from Tiffany Genders.
Some of the 16 women arrested this morning are being questioned here at Fairfield Police Station over their alleged roles in this major taxpayer rort. They are mothers accused of handing over their children's identities in exchange for cash. To authorities, it appeared these kids were receiving childcare at centres belonging to the Red Roses network. There were playgrounds, photos, timesheets and rosters which made it all look legitimate. But in May, police announced it was all fake. The agency was allegedly set up to defraud the federal government's childcare subsidy scheme, raking in an estimated $3.8 million a year, the suspected director around 30 grand a week. Today's raids come on top of 8 arrests made on Tuesday and another 17 in May. In total, 41 people have been accused of involvement in this pyramid scheme.
Terrifying body cam footage has captured the moment two police officers drove directly into Queensland's Perigian firestorm to rescue residents. Adam Hegarty spoke with them this morning.
Well, throughout this bushfire emergency on Queensland's Sunshine Coast, we've seen some extraordinary and quite frankly terrifying pictures of this fire as it took hold, but none have been more dramatic than this. Vision released by Queensland Police showing four of its officers riding and driving fearlessly into this firestorm at Perigian Beach. That is the area where a home was lost and several others were damaged. Their mission here on that Monday afternoon was to go door to door, frantically evacuating residents. You can see the fire that they had to contend with. It was completely out of control, and you can see visibility was almost non-existent with those thick plumes of black smoke. Have a listen to the ordeal.
North, go north, mate.
No worries.
Lead the way.
Copy that.
Keep going north. I'm going to give you a hand, mate. There's a fire coming. Yeah. We're going to leave now.
How far?
It's the house is burning behind you. You're almost there, mate. Yeah.
Now, the very latest on this fire this morning is it has been put out, but police have charged two people, a 14-year-old boy and a 15-year-old girl, accusing them of deliberately lighting that fire. Also this morning, we've spoken to two of the officers involved in these evacuations.
I now understand what a firestorm is, and it's not something you'd want to go into. And honestly, the only thing that was going through my mind, I could probably, I know Cameron as well, is that just to get as many people out as quickly as possible to get them to safety.
We're only here because it was our vision that was used, but there was a lot of guys doing exactly the same thing.
Now, reinforcement firefighters from interstate and also locally here in Queensland have come in to give those firefighters who have been on the front line for 48 hours a much needed break, but of course, bushfire season has only just begun.
Adam Hegarty there. Meanwhile, the clean-up is right now underway in Binnaburra, the Gold Coast hinterland community, in recovery mode after the region was scorched by devastating bushfires. Exclusion zones will be opened throughout the day, revealing the full scale of destruction to residents. The hot and windy weather is expected to ease, but the forecast suggests conditions could deteriorate again next week. Well, for the latest in federal politics now, let's cross straight to reporter Kerry Yaxley. Kerry, the Prime Minister has just spoken about the Gladys Liu drama.
Yeah, he has, Mark. He strongly defended Gladys Liu as other members of the government rally around her this morning. Labor and crossbenchers tried to force Miss Liu to give an explanation to the House of Representatives while it was dividing. The PM and the Treasurer sat next to Miss Liu. Clearly, optics are very important in politics. The PM then held a press conference to defend her. It comes as Labor and others ask whether Miss Liu is loyal to Australia first and foremost. Earlier this week, she gave a disastrous television interview. She failed to clarify her association with groups that supposedly have links to the Chinese Communist Party's propaganda arm. Then in a written statement, she confirmed that she had been a member of some of these groups, but she is no longer a member, honorary or otherwise. The Prime Minister today stopped just short of suggesting that those asking the questions about her loyalty are being racist.
There's 1.2 million Australians of Chinese heritage in this country. This has a very grubby undertone in terms of the smear that is being placed on Gladys Liu. And I think people should reflect very carefully in the way they've sought to attack Gladys over this matter and the broader smear that I think that is implied in that.
And Mark, today is an historic day for the upper house. Another female senator was sworn in, meaning the Senate has reached equal representation between men and women for the first time ever. Sarah Henderson won a pre-selection contest over the weekend to take a vacant spot for the Liberals. The numbers, however, in the house are not even close to equal, Mark, less than a third, in fact.
Kerry Yaxley in Canberra, thank you. Well, there's been an unconfirmed sighting of two missing campers in country Victoria. Lana Murphy has the latest.
The search is now well into its fourth day and is now being assisted by motorcycle police and the Mounted Branch, who have arrived here in West Gippsland from Melbourne in an effort to help find Caleb Forbes and Shannon Loudon. The young couple could be anywhere within a 1,000 square kilometre region here around the Thompson Dam. That's where they told their family they were heading for a one-night camping trip on Friday. But of course, the alarm was raised when Caleb didn't show up for work as an apprentice electrician on Sunday. Many of his colleagues, as well as Shannon's family, have joined the search here, assisting the police search and rescue and the SES as they canvass the perimeter of Thompson Dam. There has been an unconfirmed sighting around the Denali's Creek area, but of course police are continuing to canvass northwest of there along the Woods Point area, which is more rugged and snow-capped. Police do believe the young couple have food and a sleeping bag, and they believe that they may have become bogged in the wet weather across the weekend. Anyone with any information is urged to come forward.
The two Australian bloggers detained in an Iranian prison have been identified as a couple from Perth. Jolie King and Mark Firkin have been documenting their travels on social media since 2017 and were reportedly arrested for flying a drone without a licence near Tehran 10 weeks ago.
These are always very sensitive cases, and they're never issues that are addressed well by offering public commentary on them. And I note that in at least one of these cases, that's a view that's been expressed by family members. So we will continue to pursue these matters in the interests of the Australians who are at the centre of these cases, and we will do that carefully, and we'll do that in close consultation through our officials who have been part of this process now for some time. And I'll respect the wishes of the family, and I'll respect the best interests of those citizens.
A former Melbourne University lecturer is also reportedly being held over a separate incident.
Hi YouTubers, I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching Great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at 9news.com.au.